said.
Hi, scientist?
Yeah, I'm a scientist, squirrel? Right? I'm a squirrel scientist.
Well, you're right. Everybody is a scientist. So hi, scientist. Yes, I'm Evelyn. How can I help you?
Yeah, I want to know, is the science center open? I'm outside the Rose Garden, and I really want to go in and see what's going on.
So the science center is still closed. I know, I'm sorry. Well, we have lots of animals at the science center, and we have this rule where we don't let other animals in to protect the animals that are living there.
Oh.
Opened. I don't know if you could come and visit us, scientist.
Oh, that's okay, Evelyn. I can watch from outside like I always do.
You know what? I have an idea. I have been really lucky. And I think maybe if you want to be able to explore the science center, I can help you out with that.
So you'll let me in your bag?
Not quite.
Sparkly eyes. Do,
just like you did now, you can video chat me. So I will send you my information. I'll let you know the next time I'm at the Science Center and we can explore some of those exhibits together. And maybe we'll get a chance to meet some of my friends at the Science Center and get some stuff that most people wouldn't be able to see if they were to just visit the Science Center.
So it's like a personal tour? That sounds cool.
Yeah? All right. Well then, I'll see you next time.
See you next time, Evelyn. Thanks.
Hi, Evelyn. It's me.
Hi, scientist. I thought you had forgotten. I've been waiting for a little while.
I know. It took a little while. I'm sorry.
That's okay. This is our first time doing this together, So... Welcome to World of Life. Like I said, I'll try to show you some of those things that maybe you won't be able to see because you can't come into the science center. Mm-hmm. So I am starting in a place that I really, really like. Okay? And you know what? I have this thing that I want to show you. Don't get too grossed out.
Okay? Uh-huh.
Ready?
Whoa! Is that a real heart?
This is a real human heart. And you can see some tubes, which we call veins and arteries, and you can see them on the outside as well. Isn't that cool?
It's really cool. It's really gross. I want to touch it too.
It is really cool. I don't think it's very gross, but I do think it's really cool.
Okay.
Now, I guess, do you have a heart?
I think I do. I did some exercise in the morning, Evelyn, because you know I'm trying to stay in shape while I'm staying at home. And something in my chest went bump, 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 bump after I did all my exercise.
So one really cool thing is that mammals have hearts. And not all hearts are the same size. And some have bigger hearts, some have smaller hearts. Now, if I were to take my hand, my heart is about the size of my hand. Now, that's not the same for you, but for humans, that's an easy way to figure that out. And you're right, you can sometimes feel your heart beating.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you can feel it a lot, and sometimes you can't at all. Mm-hmm. Now, I want us to try something together. So I want you to take your two fingers.
Got it.
Just like me.
Uh-huh.
And place them right under, very gently, your neck.
Uh-huh.
And you can slowly move them around, but you have to be really still for this part.
I'm trying. Oh, I feel something.
Move them around until you feel a really, really gentle tap back. Mm-hmm. So you are feeling your heart pumping blood throughout your body.
Whoa.
And sometimes we do things that force our heart to pump faster.
Mm-hmm.
So you said you were trying to get in shape.
Uh-huh.
I'm actually going to have you do something
That's
going to make your heart pump faster. Ready?
Uh-oh. Okay.
We are going to do some jumping jacks. Wait, can squirrels do jumping jacks?
I can try.
Try it. Let's just try it.
Okay.
We're going to do 10 jumping jacks.
Okay.
Ready?
10.
And go.
Okay. One.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay.
I want you to
stop and do it again.
Okay.
How does it feel now?
Well, it's super fast now, and I think I might.
Just take a deep breath.
Okay.
And then breathe out. That might help. Now, as you're breathing in.
Uh-huh.
and breathing out. What are you breathing in and what are you breathing out?
It's air.
Yeah. So we breathe in air, and what we actually want is the oxygen. Uh-huh. So our lungs work with our heart to get oxygen all over our body. So we breathe it in. It first goes to the lungs. The heart sends blood to the lungs to pick up that oxygen. Uh-huh. Then that blood goes back to the heart. Wow. And then the heart pumps it all over your body.
So,
and it's constantly happening.
Wow. So every time I take a breath, my lungs get bigger. And then the blood goes through all my body. And the heart's the one pumping all of that?
Yes.
That's
so
a lot of work.
You are constantly breathing. And your heart is constantly beating or pumping. And doctors are actually really interested in that beating. And sometimes when you've been to the doctor, maybe you've had them use something like this.
Yeah, I remember that. They put that all over. They put it on your back, on your chest.
They're listening in. Sometimes it's actually something that goes over your finger.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's something that goes wrapped around your arm. And what they're doing is they're trying to find what we call your heart rate. And that heart rate can tell us a whole lot about how your heart is doing and how healthy it is. Sometimes doctors want to give us advice because our heart has to do so much work all the time that we want to make sure that we're keeping it as healthy as we can.
It does a lot. I really do want to take care of my heart, Evelyn.
Yeah. So one way is to just go out and walk a little bit more.
Uh-huh.
You could also try to eat healthier. And let's see, what else?
Ooh, healthy eating. I know. I've done that.
Everybody does it. It's okay to eat junk food. We just have to make sure that we balance everything out. Mm-hmm. And the last one is sleeping. I know sleeping can get kind of tough. But scientist, we have to go. I'm sorry. We started a little bit late today. But the next time, we'll have something really, really fun. And next time, I actually want you to meet one of my friends. So you'll see how that goes, okay?
Okay.
All right. Bye, scientist. See you next time.
Bye,
hope you're feeling a little less stuck at home.
You too.
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.